Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So this video is going to be on what I do as a software engineer and how can we switch to my domain. Like most of my friends ask that how they can switch to my domain. I thought maybe someone else is having that question. This video might be helpful for them. Like there is a construction work going on, so there might be a lot of noise in this video, but I can't do anything because I stay here. So yeah, let's get into the video. The domain which I'm currently working in is DevOps. I do work as a DevOps engineer, like from the beginning of my career. In my first company in Wipro, when I received the training, so it was for everything. I learned .NET, I learned Python, Java, scripting, everything. And in my college also, I used to learn everything, database, Java, like end-to-end project. When you join your first company, so project which you work, so your most of the career or the domain, like mostly for me, got decided that time only. When you go for your first company, so always choose your domain wisely. Let's talk first what is DevOps. So as the name suggests, if you'll break the names, DevOps, it means development plus operations. Let's say I'll give you an example. So there is a team who wrote the code and that's it, their job is done. Now there would be another team whose responsibility is to pack the code and deploy that code in the production. Production is something which is live. Suppose you are opening a website and you are booking a ticket. So that means code is live. The code which is behind the booking or ticketing, it is on production. Here the DevOps comes into the picture. Like we used to automate things. We used to define the architecture, how we are going to pack the code, which server we are going to use, at what frequency the code will be deployed. It should be automated. It will need a manual approval. Based on that, we also have to keep in mind that this architecture should not cost much to the company and we should get it an optimized way. This is what DevOps is all about. So we used to have lot of tools for CI/CD deployment. CI/CD is nothing but continuous integration and continuous deployment. So let's say so there are multiple developers, a number of developers, they are writing the code and they are putting their code in a repository. That repository will be having some automated tests. So it will do the testing of the complete code, and if there is something wrong with the code, they will just send a feedback to the developers and they will fix it. This is like a agile methodology where developers are getting the feedback and they're testing it. This is what we call continuous integration. The next phase in DevOps is like continuous delivery and continuous deployment. So continuous delivery is nothing but like suppose your complete code for the application or the software which you're working is ready. So it needs a manual approval. Someone needs to approve manually to put that complete code to the production. Whereas continuous deployment is like same as continuous integration. Suppose you need to deploy some feature, new feature into your existing code, so you just need to write that code. Like there are some automated tests, so if it will pass, then your code will be automatically deployed to production. It just don't need any manual approval. So this is called continuous deployment. So using DevOps methodology, companies are able to complete their deliverables in less time. So most of the companies are opting the DevOps methodology nowadays. This is the basic of DevOps, what the CI/CD means. So behind that, a lot of things going on. We do have a lot of tools for doing all this process. So I'll tell you some basic tools which we use. So we can categorize these tools as some tools for continuous integrations and some for continuous deployment. So some of the tools are like Jenkins, Ansible, Chef. Jenkins is like CI/CD tool. Suppose from your repository you wrote the code, so there would be a Jenkins file. So Jenkins file will be having those steps how your pipeline is going to be executed. Suppose first stage is continuous integration, second stage is binding those packages in your EAR var files, third stage might be like you need to put those artifacts like that EAR and jar file in some artifactory. So I have worked on two. One is JFrog artifactory and the other is Nexus. And then in the next stage, continuous deployment, environment, your pipeline would go to that Artifactory using some tokens. Like they will pick up that package and they will deploy that package to the server which you have defined. Second tool you need to learn is Maven. That is some continuous integration tool that is having a pom.xml where you use to define how your code is going to pack, what extension they are going to use. If you learn pom.xml, so most of the things you will know. You have some tools like Ansible and Chef. We used to call them infrastructure as code. Suppose you write something, you want to deploy some new feature to the server. So there will be multiple servers. You cannot go one by one and deploy your code everywhere. So here Ansible or Chef comes into picture. Like they are using some keys to go to each server and write your code. So Ansible and Chef are having some slight difference. You will go deep, so you will understand. We do have a release management tool that is Digital AI. We used to call it XLR previously. In my first company, I have worked in Digital AI, and from that time till now, it has enhanced a lot. It's wonderful. Like we can define our automated steps, we can define our manual steps there in order to create the pipeline. We can define everything for our release management, and we can schedule it as well. So it is wonderful. And currently, I'm working on Digital AI. So for learning Digital AI, you need to learn Jython, that is Java plus Python, and you can create your own plugin there. You can do whatever you want for which is required to your release. It is very, very good actually. Right now my project is required with GitLab runner. It is an inbuilt feature in GitLab itself which used to pack your code into artifacts, and you can download your artifact from GitLab itself. Currently for cost optimization we are using GitLab runner. We used to define everything in our ci.yaml, and the scripting you need to learn is some bash scripting, PowerShell and Groovy scripting. Like scripting language you need to learn. You can learn just one, and you can Groovy is little bit, I will say, difficult, but otherwise bash, PowerShell, etc., they are quite similar. You just need to learn the syntax of every scripting and it will be fine. Like if you want to switch to DevOps, you should learn it because they are very frequently used there. Apart from that, there are other tools as well for code monitoring and cloud. Why I'm forgetting the cloud? Currently cloud is the most demanding thing in DevOps. You need to learn one cloud, either it should be GCP, Azure or AWS or PCF as well. Like I think most of the things are same when you go to cloud. Like I had worked on PCF, that is Pivot Cloud Found. Basic difference of like when we switch to cloud is previously we used to deploy on servers, but now we are deploying it on cloud, which is everything is on cloud. So cloud do provide lot of services for monitoring your application. Yeah, you can do the certification as well, like I did Azure 900 is the basic one, so you can try doing that. Coming to me, what I'm doing right now, so we do have the code in mainframe servers which is very old. My team is defining an architecture, we are deciding the tools which we are going to use, and we are creating a pathway for automating those tasks which they are manually doing. When you want to switch to the person which are working since years into some automation, so they are very skeptical that how they can adapt those things, whether it will work or not. So DevOps is also something where you need to convince other teams that they should use it. We should be very crisp clear that we are going to convince them to use the DevOps. So yeah, so I just gave the blueprint how things are working in DevOps and what you can learn. Basic you can learn if you really want to switch to DevOps. So I hope in this video you found some useful information which can help you in your IT journey. If you have any question, then you can comment below. I will definitely try to answer that. And if you want to see some contents like this, then you can go to my YouTube channel and scroll the videos. If you find something interesting, then you can consider subscribing. I will see you in next video. Until bye.